Baby walkers raise a lot of controversy, both among parents and among medics. The information on the internet is a kind of tug of war between marketing, ads, articles posted by manufacturers encouraging parents to buy this kind of stuff, and between scientific knowledge and clinical observations where others say don't. And I know that by creating this movie, I will make the industry that produces this kind of equipment very angry, and I expect some negative comments or thumbs down, but honestly, I don't care. I want to tell you what I, as a physical therapist, think about all kinds of developmental aids like baby walkers, push walkers, and jumpers. I don't like them, I do not recommend to use them, and I will tell you why. But there is a country where the sale of baby walkers is prohibited by law. It's Canada. In 2004, the Canadian federal government banned the baby walkers because of the danger they may cause. Since then, it's illegal to import, advertise for sale, or sell baby walkers in Canada. The main concern were head injuries as babies stumbled downstairs while they were in the walker. In the 90s, in the US, the number of accidents related to the use of baby walkers fluctuated around a dozen thousand per year. The situation has improved significantly thanks to the increased knowledge of the risks associated with the use of such devices and thanks to voluntary safety improvements made by manufacturers. However, to this day, hundreds of children still go to the emergency room each year. Children who suffered various types of injuries while using the walker. Baby walker-related injuries can be severe and can include skull fracture, brain injury, burns, poisoning, or even drowning. But I won't talk about it today. As a physiotherapist, I would like to draw your attention to another aspect of the use of baby walkers, how they negatively affect the body's motor skills and the gait patterns produced. Let's start with the fact that the main motivation for the parents to buy a walker is that their child is not yet walking and needs some help. Meanwhile, all studies clearly show that using a baby walker will not speed up the moment your baby starts walking. Here you got the articles and you can find all the links in the movie description. Moreover, the use of baby walker can cause a number of anomalies within the generated gait pattern. In order for the child to maintain a vertical body posture and learn to load both the right and the left foot, it is necessary to experience the ground reaction forces. Ground reaction force is the force exerted by the ground on a body in contact with it. In other words, the child has to try out, has to learn how to put the foot, which muscles to tighten, which muscles to relax, to maintain the upright posture, and to be able to balance in this position. If we offer the child a baby walker or a push walker, then he or she starts to react with the upper torso. In this case, the center of gravity is shifted forward, which is a not natural physiological stage in building a gait pattern. Especially in the case of baby walkers, the child begins to push with his toes without building up the correct heel loading. Instead of building the stability in contact with the ground with ground reaction forces, the child starts to build it from the top. A very important study has recently been published comparing two groups of children. One used a walker and the other did not. A specialized study was performed using the three-dimensional motion analysis system. The children who used baby walkers had lower gait speed, specifically in the first, third, fourth, and fifth months after gait acquisition, and longer duration of stance and swing phases than children who didn't use walkers. Additionally, children who used baby walkers had smaller knee amplitude and greater hip amplitude in sagittal plane than children who didn't use walkers in the week of gait acquisition. Let us add that in this study, in both groups, they were healthy children not burdened with genetic or neurological deficits. So you can see that walkers can provoke a wrong gait pattern and simply they shouldn't be used. Along with growing awareness of the harmfulness of the walkers, baby walkers, and other helpers have appeared on the market. Among them, we can find push walkers like this one or baby jumpers. And here it is also worth saying a few words. Push walkers, also a bad idea in my opinion, because as the baby walkers, they provoke the formation of pathological gait patterns. When we look at a child who cannot yet walk on his own, to whom we propose a push walker, it's clear that the body weight is shifted forward and the child again strongly engages the upper limbs to gain balance. When working with such a device, the child must walk quickly because he or she moves the device forward by leaning on the handle. Such a fast walk unfortunately forces the forefoot to be overloaded and the child does not work out a good heel strike. This, in turn, may disturb proper loading response and mid-stance phase of the gait in the future. Regarding jumpers, well, they strongly provoke plantar flexion of the foot and push of the toes. Because such a child does not weight the heel properly, a frequent consequence is the development of a toe gait in the future, which may require long rehabilitation. And everything I'm talking about, I see in my patients. Children who are referred for rehabilitation due to incorrect foot loading, toe gait, incorrect gait patterns, in most cases used this type of devices in the past. And of course, some of you can tell me that your baby used a baby walker, used a push walker or a jumper and nothing happened. Everything is okay, your baby is walking, everything is fine. And let me tell you this, lucky you, because you had a healthy child who managed to cope with the challenges that such a device caused. But if, for example, your baby had an asymmetry, decreased or increased muscle tone, or had other abnormal movement patterns in the earliest stages of development, then, believe me, these types of device can really cause a big problem. Summing up, dear parents, don't use these devices. Let the nature do the job. Give your child time to experience the reaction with the ground and to build the correct pattern of foot loading, which will result in correct gait in the future. Your child will fall over and over and over again, but believe me, it is extremely necessary. Every fall, every loss of balance is an extremely valuable lesson for a young, shaping body. Of course, when your child starts to stand by objects, take the first steps, we need to provide him with a safe environment. Secure the sharp edges, make sure your child does not pull anything off the table so that he does not throw anything on himself, but do not help him with the walker or pusher or any other magical device because you're not really going to help him at all. At the very end, I would like to tell you one more thing. Nowadays, I see a big fashion or pressure for the kids to do everything very, very quickly. Moms are competing on social media that, for example, my baby is already sitting or my baby is already walking, which really influences a lot of people around. And really, it happens that there are parents who come to my office with the child who turned 1 year old, for example, 1 week ago, and the baby is not walking. When such a child is crawling symmetrically, is standing by the objects, we have nothing to worry about. Remember that the developmental window for gait is between 9, 10, usually 12 months to 18 months. And I know really a lot of kids who started walking when they were 1.5 years old. And their development is absolutely normal, absolutely correct. So don't be influenced by the environment. Give your child time. And if you have any doubts related to your child's development, go to see a medic, go to see a doctor, or go to see a physical therapist. And that's all. Links to all scientific sources are, as usual, in the movie description. If you like the movie, leave it a thumb up, leave a comment, share this video with others, and of course subscribe to the channel for more videos on physiotherapy. Thanks for watching. Bye.